Yeah, let's start with some breathing, our face down breathing. We're gonna do 5 breaths. We call our crocodile breathing. Forehead resting gently on our fists overhead. And then we're gonna go from there. We're gonna do some rolling patterns today. Just a lot of goodness. Stuff to make us hopefully move well. That's the goal, right? All right, so let's start with our breathing. So you can do 5 full breaths. Remember, just a couple reminders with the breathing. On the inhale, you want your rib cage to expand all the way around. So this way, pop the back so the rib cage should actually move. And then as we exhale, everything just settles. So full inhale, maybe hold that breath for a second or two after you get all that air in. Let it all out. Brief pause, 5 times, then we move on. And hopefully the cameras are set up good. I figure after all this time, I've at least figured that part out. So, also having some problems with my other tripod, but anyway, I'm talking way too much. Let's keep moving. Alright, so as I mentioned, we're going to go back to our rolling patterns. So the first set here, we're going to use our upper body to drive the movement. So again, these are a great way to kind of get our upper body moving independently of our lower body, kind of wake up some of those deep core muscles, for lack of a better word, even though I know that term is used in such a general way these days. But so we're going to do that. So again, when we set up, we're going to lie on our back, arms overhead. Lower body is unmoving, so just relax it. It should be limp and really not contribute to the rolling pattern as we roll over and we roll back. Excuse me. We'll do 5 to either side. Again, using that upper body to drive the movement. So we're going to arms overhead. And again, remember, what could be a helpful cue? Our body or our spine will tend to follow whatever our neck does. So once we set up, we can flex our neck, look in the direction we want to roll, use that arm, and roll over. Gonna do the same thing for the way back. And that's one. We got 4 more to this side. keep the hips and lower body out of the movement. We're going to do our pullover, so if you have a kettlebell or dumbbell handy, or even any type of small weighted object that you can hold on to securely will work, or you can just do any dead bug variation, anyone works. And adding a weight will increase the challenge. Again, just to kind of reiterate what these exercises are doing, really helping us avoid excessively arching through our lower back. So kind of keeping your rib cage and pelvis facing each other or stacked on top of each other to keep that good spine position. Keep it braced again as we add movement. Right, so we'll do any variation. You can keep your feet down, arms go overhead. As you exhale, you want to go overhead as far as you can without letting that low back arch. You can also bring your hips and knees up in the air. You can also add a lower body dead bug pattern. It's completely up to you. All right, so again, to set up, think about reaching towards the ceiling with that weight. As you exhale, kind of feel your pelvis tilt backwards, your low back flatten out, and this is the position we want to keep. You can even practice inhaling without losing that position. I'm going to bring my legs up for this one. Another inhale as I exhale. Controlled manner overhead. Without arching that back. Let's do like 8 to 10 repetitions. Alright, so now we're going to do some hip rotation side to side, and we're going to finish. We're going to go 5 per side, and I will demonstrate that. It's one you've done before. So again, a great way just to mobilize the hips as we rotate side to side. The key then again is to keep that upper body kind of static, unmoving, shoulder blades and arms on the floor. Then we're going to finish off with holding one side for 5 full breaths, the other side for 5 full breaths. I will explain it when we get there. So again, lying on your back, arms out. Make sure your head is touching the floor. Kind of chin gently tucked in. Shoulder blades, arms, head stay in contact with the ground. Be You can keep your feet down, and we're just going to rotate side to side. You can bring your legs up if you can, if that works for you. Or just keep them down. Five to each side. You can add some neck rotations. So as I drop my legs towards my right side, I can look over my left shoulder. And then just do the opposite as I drop them to the other side. Make sure you're breathing. Just let your body settle into the range of motion it can control. One more to each direction. Alright, now what we're going to do, we're going to straighten one leg, put it on the ground. Again, shoulder blades and head stay on the ground. And take one hand and then gently bring that hip across. Look over the opposite shoulder. And then from here, I'm just going to do 5 full breaths. As I exhale, I might be able to get a little bit more range of motion. Now we're going to switch sides. That leg straightens out. Bring that other leg across. Rotate your head the opposite way. And breathe. Feeling good. All right, last thing in the circuit that we're going to do, I'm just going to go grab a chair. So if you have a chair or a stool or even a low table handy, grab that. One of my favorite stretches or mobilizations, and what we've been doing recently. Great way to get a little bit more movement this way in our mid-spine without arching our lower back. Also a great way to lengthen those muscles, those main mid-back muscles that we have here. Sometimes they get really short and tight depending on the positions we're in or the activities we engage in. This is a great way to kind of release them, make your mid-upper back feel so much better. You're getting pain in your neck up into your head, that could also be the culprit. So really awesome exercise. So basically what we're going to do is arms straight on your chair, your stool, or table. You're going to take a nice inhale in, and then we're going to rock back as we exhale. So you're trying to bring your chest down towards your thighs. As you sit back on your heels, and then come back up. We're going to do 8 total. That was 1. halfway. If that position bothers your knees, you can also do that. I have these ballet bars here, which work great. Back of a chair, table, sink, something like that. So basically, very similar. Just hold on to hopefully a stationary object. Bend those knees a little bit. And then we're just going to push those hips back as we drop our chest down towards our thighs. So you can also do this in a standing position again. If kneeling bothers your knees. All right, so back to the top, we're gonna do another set of the rolling pattern. We're gonna keep with the upper body driving the movement, lower bodies just along for the ride. We'll do five more per side. And we're gonna start with arms overhead. You're going to flex the neck, look in the direction you want to rotate, and roll. Same thing on the way back. Set up on the other side, five more. Over, a dig bug variation is next. Again, 8 to 10 controlled repetitions that you're doing, extending one leg as you bring the kettlebell or your weight overhead. I would say 4-5 per side for that total of 8 to 10 reps. So just whatever position you can control, that low back, and really feel those abs. Stay nice and tight. That's the one I want you to select. So again, about reaching with that weight towards the ceiling as you exhale. This basically sets our position, kind of tilts my pelvis back, flattening out my low back, bringing my ribs down, and really firing up those front side ab muscles. I want to make sure I maintain that position as I add the movement and I continue to breathe. finish with a hold, kind of stretching out those posterior hip muscles either side to finish the set. So again, legs up or down. Make sure you're keeping that upper body nice and stable. Arms, shoulder blades, and head stay on the ground. And then just drop the hips to one side as you rotate your head the opposite way. Make sure you're breathing. Just let your body settle in again to that range of motion you can control. Straighten out one leg. Look over that opposite shoulder as you just gently bring that leg across. 5 full breaths. Chair, as long as it's stable. Good variation again if it bothers being kneeling, if your kneeling position bothers your knee, your knees. Alright. Here we go. We're just gonna sit back on our heels as we exhale. Bring that chest down towards our thighs. Again, just let your body settle into whatever position it can go to. Without forcing it, using your breathing. 8 total, we got 7 more. finish up with another breathing drill. We did this one a couple of weeks ago. It's called the Bretzel. So basically we're going to be stretching out or mobilizing the front of the hip and then also adding some mid spine rotation to it. We're just going to do 5 or 6 breaths to either side to finish off today's class. So I'll actually do it in this position here. Hopefully you guys can see it. So the bottom leg, I'm going to take, grab that ankle. Top leg with the other arm, just kind of bring it across. And then basically what I want to try to do is get my shoulder blades as close to the ground as possible. Alright? So my left side here, as I do the breathing, I'm going to try to settle that shoulder blade as close to the floor as I can. So we're going to do 5 or 6 breaths. Here we go. Same thing on the other side. Again, that bottom leg, one arm, kind of clasp that ankle. Try to bring your heels close to your butt as you can. Other hand, grasp that top leg, put your head down on the ground, and just inhale and exhale. 6 good breaths. Try to get both shoulder blades as close to the ground as you can. You can actually rotate your head to that side as you breathe. We will stop there for today. This will be up on YouTube later today or even by tomorrow. Again, check it out. Check out our YouTube channel. We got a whole bunch of different things. We got some yoga. We got fitness with Gina. We got some wellness talks. We got exercise breakdowns, exercise of the week. In fact, the last 2 weeks have been dead bug variations and then kettlebell pullover. So if you have some issues with some of those exercises, check out those videos. Hopefully they're helpful to you. And have an awesome weekend. See you all next week.